Hi guys, thank you so much for checking out this video. Please subscribe to support my channel, I really appreciate it. In this video, I want to share with you guys one of my favorite bags from Chanel. And this is also my hubby's favorite bag. He just said today that he loves the chain and how everything is oversized. Here is the dust bag, it has the drawstring opening and Chanel logo in the front. This is the largest bag I've got in my collection. Just a side note, the lighting in this video is very bright and it's sun outside, so here you can see every little detail of the bag. The dust bag and the bag seems brighter, but in reality they are a true black. I found this beautiful picture of Claudia Schiffer and the same bag in tweed. I absolutely love everything about this picture. And here she is. The Chanel 2.55 XXL handbag or reissue. It is in black tweed and it's got the ruthenium hardware. The measurements on this one are 19 inches in length, 5 inches in width, 13 inches in height. I absolutely love this oversized huge bag. It came with the authenticity card and it has the serial number engraved at the back of the card. This number matches the serial sticker inside the bag. It also came with the care booklet and info card. Here you can see the front of the bag. It has the Mademoiselle turn lock at the front. Here is the top of the bag. The quilts are huge. There are 4 quilts between the grommets. Here you can see the side and how the flap folds over the bag. And here is a shot of the other side. Here are the corners of the bag. The corners are in a pretty good condition, considering that it is from the 2009 fall winter collection. I think that it has held up pretty well. Here is the bottom of the bag. You can see that there is a crease in the middle, and that is because it is possible to fold it flat. I will show you that later in the video. Let's have a closer look at the back of the bag. It has a large Mona Lisa pocket in the back. It has the same black interior lining as inside of the bag. The Mademoiselle lock opens by turning it. We can see that Chanel is engraved at the bottom of the lock. And at the back of the lock, we can see that the screws used here are flat. The bag has 4 grommets, which are huge. The chain runs through them, and here is a shot of the grommets inside the bag. They are attached with Torx-shaped screws. Let's take a closer look at the chain. The middle one has a design all the way through, while the 2 on the sides are plain. The chain has a 14-inch drop or a 24-inch drop at the longest, which means that I can wear it with double chain on the shoulder or drag it out into a single chain and I can wear it as a crossbody. This isn't a structured bag. I use a lot of styrofoam to keep it structured. just to keep it standing on my shelf or display. Let me just take out the styrofoam. The bag will lose its structure when I take it out. It is just a personal reference that I like it to be fully structured. Here you can see what it looks like when I take out the support. It has a black lanyard with a silver lobster claw clasp to attach keys or maybe a pouch of some sort. I really love the interior lining in black, and here you can see how huge it is inside. The stamp is in silver and it says Chanel made in Italy. It has a zipper pull pocket that is huge. The zipper pull is in ruthenium hardware. It has Chanel engraved on one side and double CCs on the other side. The zipper opens up and closes nicely. And the pocket goes all the way down to the bottom. On the other side there are two slit pockets. One large and one slightly smaller one. I pull out the lining so I can show you better. It's easier to see the slit pockets. In the right corner is the serial number. It has the 2cc in gold with circles around it, the serial number and some glitter. And the plastic that has covered it has some crosses on it. It is a seal, so if you try to take it off, it will get ruined. It is possible to store it flat like this. So I put in the support again because I want this bag to be fully structured. I think it looks prettiest when it's filled. I usually don't store the bag in a desk bag, This one I have on display, either on the shelf or on the drawer, so that I can see this beauty every day. And here you can see how it's displayed in the closet. And here you can see how it's on the drawer. Here it is compared to my reissue 255 in caviar leather. If I put it inside the bag, it looks tiny in comparison, but just to give you an idea of how large it is. I can fit an iPhone 8 and an iPhone 10, and there is still plenty of room, so I could probably fit in one more. The iPad mini fits as well. The iPad Pro 11 inch goes as well. It does rise a little bit above the pocket, but it's not too much, so I think it works. The Louis Vuitton Etui Voyage. It does stick a little bit up from the pocket, but I think it is cute. This bag was released in different colors and materials. Here are some pictures that I found online, but there could be even more variations. I wish I could get them all, but I'm really happy that I was so lucky to get the one. I keep a lookout for these on Fashion File, The Luxury Closet, The Real Real, eBay, everywhere. In my opinion, these get sold pretty fast. I got this pre-loved from Fashion File. This was my first purchase from them, and I did get it some time ago in December 2014. It was listed as excellent condition with light surface wear and a crease on the bottom. And here you can see the receipt. I waited for the 30% discount to kick in. After shipping and discount, the total was $1,153.94 plus an additional 25% for customs to get it into Norway. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really enjoyed making it. And if you haven't already subscribed, please hit that subscribe button to support my channel. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys soon.